Hi, Alex here from redeveloper.com and welcome back to the channel and welcome back to this awesome tutorial series on how you can add Swift UI elements in UIKit. You heard that right, Swift UI elements in UIKit. And today we are going to talk about images, so let's get started. Okay. In the previous episode, I have talked about UI buttons and how you can observe them and how you can react on that observe with, a log of success tabbed. Now, today we are going to talk about images. So let me just remove all of this so I don't get all of that warnings, and I just remove the button too. And there we go. We are just leaving the stack and let me just go back there so you can see a lot more of the code. So, images. Well, if you take a look at Duck UI, you go into the UI image view, because yeah, that is what we are using. You can see that there aren't a lot, but there are quite powerful. So we have a background color, a circular that sets the image to a circular, so around it. Inserts, frame, height, and width. Yeah, basically that's it. And we are going to cover these in this episode, and we are going to create, first of all, let's create an image view. So let image view, that is a UI image view. So yeah, basic. And we are going to add that image view into our stack, vertical stack. But before we do that, let me just create a horizontal stack, because I want to make it, some sort of a squared. So yeah, you will learn how to add in here. So yeah, layoutless, again, layoutless. You could use a simple stack, but for some reason, this project needs to make that pretty clear that this is the stack from our layoutless framework. So I will have this as a horizontal stack. Here we go, and hit, let me just go down for the image. You hit Command Alt and the square braces and move that all the way up. So we have our image view there, and I will add in here a divider. If you don't know what the divider is, go ahead and take a look at the previous episodes. And because we are in a horizontal stack, this will be a horizontal divider. I will use this, let's use the large, because I want to push it all the way to the right. And finally, I want to add in here a spacer. So yeah, it occupies the remaining space. Now, to this to work, we want to add our image view. First of all, let's add an image view. Let's see here, an image. And let's just initiate this as with image view with an image. So there we go. And let's hit Command M to bring up our bender here, our dummy image, and just add it right there. Make sure that it is there, you can see it. Otherwise, sometimes Xcode 10 crashes. And what I will use for now is just set a frame. So frame, and this is basically a size, but with Swift UI, it uses frame. So yeah, it's just the language. So it will be a CG size. Type, let's see, width and height, I don't know, maybe for the width 300 and the height 100. Yeah, you will see. Okay, let's just hit build and run and see how this looks right now. Yeah, it's kind of stretched, so let's have this as 200. Okay, looks much better. Okay, now what can we do here? Let's go back to our UI image view. Well, basically we already set the height and width, but if you prefer to set it with the frame, you can do so. With the width and height, it's the same thing. We can have some insets that I won't cover. I've already covered padding in the previous episode. Here we have our background color and circular. So yeah, let's have our circular added here. So maybe have some circular and we have our radius of, let's say, 100. So let's remove the frame. I believe we need to do that. So let's hit Command R and see how that will look. Yeah, pretty straightforward. Now it's kind of looking stretchy, but if you do add a squared image, that will look really nice. If not, then let me just do this little hack for you. I will just remove all of this and create a lazy variable. So let lazy var, so lazy var image view, it is of type UI image view. There we have our image view, UI image view. There we go, with an image. Let's just drag and drop Bender here. There we go. And then we just return our image view. Okay. And let's add image view's content mode to be scale aspect fill. Okay, and yeah, that should be it. Let's see. What I will do though is set this to circular 100, and I would just not add it inside here. Why not add it right into the stack, just so you know that you can do that too. Now you might ask, why do I need to do this? Well, DocuWine doesn't support content mode at the moment, but most probably it will. When it will, just type in content mode, or maybe just take a look at the UI image view methods and you will see there maybe content mode. It is an evolving framework. So yeah, that is image views. And basically that is it. Now there is some issue with adding a circular, or you could have corner radiuses. I don't talk about that because we have already talked about that in the views video of our playlist. You can have any method that a view has on any child of a view, like image, UI image view, UI label, UI button, you name it. So yeah, take a look at the UI view methods. We can have edge to set corner radius, set shadow, set border. But yeah, one tiny thing with image views, you can't really have, it's kind of cumbersome to have at the same time shadows and corner radiuses. But I do have an upcoming video that explains all of that, how to do that, and that is for the SC image view, so shadow corner SC image view, that with that you can have both of them. So yeah, that is it for images in DocuUI, and that is Swift UI Elements for UIKit. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell to get notified of the next video. And that will be, let me just peek here, it will be about text fields, array, and how you can bind them to labels. Now, the next video will be so awesome. It will show another awesome part of reactive programming. So without any ado, I will see you in the next one.